Meet the Press with Hugh Riminton.
Hello, welcome to Meet the Press. Some breaking news as we go to air. The Australian aid worker Alexandra Bean has won her freedom from authorities in Libya. We'll get the details in a moment from Foreign Minister Bob Carr. He'll be joining us live from New York. Also, an Australian plan to ease the suffering in Syria. And what now for broadcaster Alan Jones? Let's begin, though, with an issue with the potential to dwarf all others. Israel says Iran, at its current rate of progress, will have a nuclear bomb in a matter of months. The implications for global security are incalculable. And if Australia succeeds next month in being elected to a seat on the UN Security Council, it will fall in part to us to sort it out. Israel says on published reports from the International Atomic Energy Agency, Iran is already more than 70% of the way there.
Where should a red line be drawn? A red line should be drawn right here, before Iran completes the second stage of nuclear enrichment necessary to make a bomb.
That, says Benjamin Netanyahu, gives until the northern spring or summer, 6-10 months at most, to act.
The United States will do what we must to prevent Iran from obtaining a nuclear weapon.
Well, Iran says it is the real victim of nuclear intimidation.
Continual threat by the uncivilized Zionists to resort to military action against our great nation is a clear example of this bitter reality.
The Obama administration does not believe Iran has yet made a final decision to create a bomb. Until it makes that decision, there is no prospect, says the US Defense Secretary, of American military action. A judgment call with enormous stakes. Another question we'll put to the Foreign Minister shortly. Meanwhile, at home, former member of the Gang of Four, Lindsay Tanner, has raised the stakes for the Labor Party. Launching a new book, he has condemned the coup against Kevin Rudd and the campaign against him since, and took aim against the Labor Party itself.
The Labor Party has lost a lot of its inner drive and impetus to incubate the big reforms, the big changes to make Australia a better place.
Lindsay Tanner has belled the cat about the contemporary Labor Party. It is a party which has lost its soul.
We went through a stage where every galah in a pet shop had an opinion about what was wrong with the Labor Party. Now, I'm sick of that. I think the public's sick of it. We've got to talk about what the Labor Party's got right.
Well, one thing Labor has always said it did get right was compulsory superannuation.
I encountered members of the ALP, supporters of the ALP across Australia, who are darn proud of their commitment to a party that gave this country Medicare and occupational superannuation.
So why now are we being led to expect a multi-billion dollar tax grab gouge out of superannuation as the government continues its desperate search for a surplus? Are we about to see Labor betray a proud Labor reform? The opposition spokesman on superannuation, Shadow Assistant Treasurer Matthias Cormann, joins us a little later on in the program. And you can join the conversation on Twitter. The hashtag is MTP10. Plenty to talk about. Bob Carr, up next.